There we go. So yoga for every body, and that's your includes your body as well, and my body, all of our bodies. So we'll begin now. We're gonna begin seated. So there we go. The sound of the bell starts us off. So it's going seated on mat ground. Let's have a little bit of a rock and roll just to feel our ground, rocking side to side, noticing how we feel. Yeah, taking this moment in the day always feels very nice to take this moment in the day just to kind of see how do you feel, absolutely completely check in with yourself and get into the body, right? So we're just going to let ourselves settle a little bit. And then sink the fingers, breathe in, and then push the hands up, stretch up, push up through the elbows, lengthen through the elbows, but really feel that the shoulders are coming down rather than having the shoulders up around the ears. So we're straining around here. We send them down. So we feel that length in the back of the neck and a space between the shoulders and the ears. And the back of the neck is long, chin is slightly tucked in. You also feel the front of the body getting really long here and strong. And we're breathing. In and out through the nostrils. Maybe starting to deepen the breath. And we do that by extending the out breath. That's the easiest way anyway, most reliable. Extend, take it right to the end of the out breath and let the in breath come in. Good. Then we'll just bring the hands together. Interlinking the fingers the other way. Still stretching up slightly, but not as much. We're just going to lean towards the side. Then use the inhale to come up, and then the exhale, leaning to the other side, and the inhale to come up. And just do a few kind of extensions through the side. So thinking about that, breathing out and breathing in to lift up to center, exhaling, breathing out to lean to the side, seeing if we can go a little further. Really have to ground the sit bones down to prevent us from toppling over, and also keep that support, feel the support in the base of the body. Inhaling one more time, exhaling, lower the arms down. And then we're just going to interlink the fingers in front of the body, breathing in. As you breathe out, take the hands forward, drop the head down, open between the upper, between the shoulder blades, between the shoulders, the upper back. So really feel the middle of your back is reaching back to the wall behind you and the hands are reaching forward. You're just looking down at your feet there. And this is where we really use the breath as well. So breathing in to the back of the body and exhaling through the nostrils and taking the hands forward, increasing the space between the chest and the hands. One more breath in and release. Let that go. See how that feels. Let's just lift the shoulders up. Inhale, let them drop. Exhale, lift them up, breathing in. Squeeze out any tension and release out through the mouth. Good. And we'll try that one more time, breathing in. And out through the mouth. Then we interlink the fingers behind the back. Let the hands just rest on the back to begin. Make the neck long. So rather than lifting the chin to lengthen the front of the throat, we're lengthening the back of the neck. So we're looking at the ground just in front of us. Inhaling, opening the front of the chest there. Taking the chest forward and exhaling, taking the hands back, shoulders back. Breathe. Inhaling. And exhaling, deepening your breath, increasing the space around your heart. Imagine that, breathing in and releasing. Yeah. And let's just stretch the legs out from here. Extend the legs out as wide as you can without overstretching there. You might want to just lift yourself up onto your fingers. You might even want to sit on a cushion. If you find yourself kind of hunched over, then sit on a cushion is better. And place the hands on the knees. And we're going to go in this big circle. So we're keeping this back really upright from the crown to the base. Here is staying long and strong. It's not kind of bending at all. You know, there's no movement there. Shoulders down, breathing in. As you breathe out, you're taking that body forwards, but in a straight line. And then we're inhaling, we're going around to the right and back. The left and then forwards. We're going in a big circle. So really, we're most of the impact really probably on the the lower back area, into the hip a little bit as well. But try and keep the body reaching out, the torso reaching out of the hips all the time. Exhaling as you take the body forwards, keep the shoulders down away from the ears. Exhaling as you come forwards. Inhaling as you lean back, holding onto the knees there. Good. And we'll go stop at the center. We're going to go the other way, but we're going to do the humming bee breath on the exhale. So inhaling, again, lengthen, lift the chest, drop the shoulders down, crown is lifting. Exhaling on a humming sound. Forwards and then to the left. When you come to the end of your hum, just start another one. We'll just do another one maybe. When you've finished your hum, just stay central for a moment and see how that feels. Hopefully cleared the passages a little bit and just got that energy buzzing. Raising your vibration by the vibration. So with that, we're going to see if there's that bit of fire there, which we're going to express through the lion. So you can take the hands to the front here. So it's either claws and take the chest forwards or out to the sides. Okay, but still a sense of going forwards, projecting forwards. And we gather ourselves, first of all, breathing in, hands together, and then yeah, let it out. All of that feeling, stuff that's gotten in the way, any kind of irritation, any kind of part that's been pushed down. We don't want that. We're going to express it instead. Express it and give it up. Breathing in. Eyes wide, tongue out the mouth, rasping throat. And again. Yes, express your aliveness with the fire of the goddess and the lion. Breathing in, let's do one more. Good, and then we just lift the knees up and bring the knees together. And we're gonna come in from going very expressive and outwards, we're going very inwards, holding our little souls into this little seed, hugging ourselves, letting the face come to the knees. So kind of really coming into ourselves. Opening the back of the neck there. Breathe into the nostrils. Have a little sigh out through the mouth. Ah, let it go. Ah, good. And then we'll just come into this little cosmic egg because it's here. So hands around the front of the knees now. Now we're going to do the opposite movement. So we're very hunched around. Now we're going to open the chest, take the shoulders back and down. Back of the neck nice and long. And really take the belly forwards, so we're on the sit bones, not sitting back on the sacrum. Really get that sense of difference there, and just come onto the tippy toes and then take the tippy toes off the floor. So we're just on our sit bones there, holding the knees and keeping them fairly close. So I've got my elbows bent here and I'm pulling my chest towards my knees, but they're not touching, and I'm breathing the whole time, floating in space. Close the eyes and see how it feels to be floating in space, your cosmic egg. One more breath in and releasing. Stretch the legs out to keep those knees a little bent, bounce up and down. Let's come into a forward bend. So legs aren't quite warmed up enough yet, so we'll just see how it is. Maybe we'll repeat it later on. So let's take the fleshy part back. And we're going to extend the arms up, breathing in. Look at the back of the hands. Take the hands forward. Take the chest forward. And just let your hands rest where they are. We're just testing the waters here for this moment. Looking at the big toes there, not looking at the knees. So if you're looking at the knees, take your gaze towards the big toes and maybe minimize, you know, maybe minimize the forward bend. Come back a little bit from it, breathing in, so that you can re-enter. We can come forwards again on the exhale, maybe come back a little bit on the inhale. Notice what is feeling tight. Backs of the thighs, most likely, maybe a little bit in the back. Keep taking the chest forward. You've already opened the chest a little bit. So breathe into that space as you inhale. And exhaling, taking the chest forwards towards the toes. Good. And now we're just going to walk the hands back up the legs. Breathing in, extend the arms up. Exhale, bring the arms down. And just bend the knees, come up into a tabletop. We're just going to hold that for a second. See, the fingers are pointing forwards, the palms are flat on the ground. You can look up at the ceiling if you want, or you can, if that doesn't feel good for your neck, you can keep your chin tucked in. And then we'll lower down on the exhale. And we'll roll onto all fours. So the other way now, at the tabletop. Get the hands on the ground. Fingers spread. The palms of the hands engaged. And the knees, the space between them, and the feet are flat behind. So we're going to move and breathe here. Inhaling, extending the right arm and the left leg. So point, extend. Exhaling, bringing the hand and knee down. Inhaling, left hand and right leg. Extend, straight line. You can do this with the heel flexed, the ankle flexed with the heel pushing away if you prefer. You can try that. Maybe I'll try that for a change. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. But we're really extending. This is a big extend on the inhale. The inhale helps us to extend and expand, and the exhale coming back down to the ground, changing your point of focus. Inhaling, exhaling. Inhaling, exhaling. Keeping the flow of the breath and staying aligned with that flow, with the movement of your body. So it's almost like you're just kind of flowing all the time, coming to this full extension and then softening, coming down to the ground, looking down at the ground, shifting the weight to go to another full extension and exhaling. Just enjoying the movement and the shifts of the body. Inhaling and exhaling. Let's do one more. Inhaling and exhaling. And we'll sit back into the heels. Take the hands forward, bring the forehead down. Open your wings up. This is the time to open the wings. Good. And the oracle card for this week just came into mind, thinking about the wings, is the Archangel Michael. So this beautiful big golden wings. And the swan, you know, you've got these big wings. You imagine the wings thrust forwards. And the oracle card, the message was, you can do it. You can do it. So you're doing it now. You're doing the yoga, which is great. And you can breathe and expand your ribs on the inhale and exhale. Ah, sigh out through the mouth. Whatever you're doing, you're lying down, if you're whatever part of the practice you're doing, make sure the breath is happening. Ah, have some releasing breath out through the mouth. Ah, good. Let's get this back a bit more mobile now. So ground the hands down, use the inhale to come up, and use the exhale to take the hips forwards. Open the chest, drop the shoulders down away from the ears. Inhaling, coming back to all fours. Exhaling, sit back. So we're really seeing how far we can sit back there. And the inhale lifts us up. And we'll see what is our range of movement, how far we can go there without pushing too hard, because we're continually moving. So that prevents us, hopefully, from doing too much pushing. Instead, we're just exploring. We're going, okay, where's happening now? How much more expansive can I make the front of the body? Looking up at the ceiling, and then we're going backwards, sitting back into the heels. The inhale always lifting us back up to all fours, and the exhale, we're just expanding the front of the body, inhaling up to all fours, exhaling, expanding the back of the body, bringing the forehead right down to the ground. Inhaling, exhaling. And let's just rest back. The next time you sit back on the heels, sit back, bring the forehead to the ground or onto a cushion if you prefer, and sweep the hands back, back of the arms on the ground, into the pose of the child. Widen the knees if you don't feel comfortable. Your body needs a bit more space. You can do that. And let the shoulders flop forward and let your mouth and cheeks and jaw get soft here. So you feel your cheeks kind of hanging, wanting to hang onto the floor. Inhale through the nostrils and then make the sound. Freeing up the mouth, lips and tongue. And again. One more time, breathing in. Good. So, mouth feeling much more lively now. Coming up to kneeling. And then we're going to take a step forward with the right foot. So we're in this kneeling position. And then we're going to come into a crescent moon. So we breathe in with the arms up. And then we're going to take the hips forward, take the hands back. So we've got this lovely crescent moon from the finger to the toe. Opening the shoulders, opening the chest. You can look up at the ceiling if your balance feels okay. If the balance feels a bit tricky, and coming up on the inhale and lowering the arms on the exhale, you can always widen your stance. Put the hands down, you can take that right foot back and then take the left foot forwards. Nice, simple exchange there. Breathing in, lift the arms up. Take the hands backwards so they're out of your line of vision. So then you have more room for the hips to go forwards on the exhale all the time, kind of. Otherwise, it's like way too much weight going forwards. It's going to feel quite strong, a bit too much. So we try and even that out, taking the hands back and lifting the chest as if the heart wants to fly up into the sky. Good. One more breath in. And exhaling, lowering the arms down. And we put the knee back again. Sit back into the heel, stretch the hands forwards. Now we're going to come up into a downward dog. So coming up onto all fours. Inhaling, toes under. Exhaling, lift the knees off the ground. And we're just going to get the backs of the legs a bit more warmed up. So bending the right knee, put the left heel down. Bending the left knee, put the right heel down. And make sure the body's long. So keep pressing back with the hands. Really imagine someone's pulling your tail upwards and backwards. The corner of the room. Breathing all the time, opening between the shoulder blades. Keeping the tummy tucked in. And instead, rather than breathing into the belly, you're breathing into the chest area. So keep those chests broad and expansive, breathing into the chest area. Then come to the stillness, just holding that posture for a second if you're still there. Breathe in and out the nostrils. And then we're going to walk the feet towards the hands. In the ragdoll, so bend the knees, let the body hang here, let the head hang. Breathe in through the nostrils, and another releasing breath out through the mouth. You can give that some sound if you want to. Ah. Let it all go. Let all your breath out. Ah. Empty, empty. Now feel that pull, the base of the spine lifting you up. See how slowly we can do this. Keep the knees bent, leave the arms hanging. Keep breathing in and out through the nostrils during this slowly unfurling standing. Slowly as you can, feel each little vertebrae lifting up, slowly unfurling, coming to standing. Come to standing and rolling the shoulders back three times, letting the knees join in, bending the knees. And then we go forward to the shoulders three times. Good. Just enjoying that movement. Oh, yeah. Hopefully shoulders should feel a little bit more warmed up now. So we're going to just wake the body up even more. And we just come to standing from the ground. So let's do our little energizer. Side of the feet together. We're going to try and squeeze everything together and also extend at the same time and hold the breath in. This is to really create our own tension. Inhale, lift the arms up, interlink the fingers, stretch up. I'll slightly move there. Lift the heels high. So we're stretching as far as we can upwards. And we're squeezing that together as well. Squeezing the sides of the head with the arms, hold the breath in. Pushing off the toes quite strongly. So we're really stretching in the feet. When we release, we release slowly through the nostrils, breathing out through the nostrils. Let the arms come down. The hands, the arms have turned as well. The palms are coming down now. So it's a very soft, bringing the heels down softly and slowly, exhaling. We'll try that again. Inhale, strong inhale, into the fingers. Strong inhale, hold that in, squeeze together and extend at the same time. So as long and squeeze together as we can make that. Hold the breath in and then let it go softly and slowly. Try not to let it whoosh out. Sometimes it's a temptation. Instead, we really experience that, all the energy we've built up, just spreading out throughout the body to the fingertips, to the toes, to the crown, everything getting expanded. Let's do one more. Inhale. And stretch up and squeeze together. Lift the heels high. Press off the toes. So we're stretching through the feet as well. Hold the breath in. And then breathing out softly. Turn the arms. Palms are coming down. The heels are coming slowly as you can down. Breathing out all the way down. Good. Take the feet a little bit apart, about shoulder width, maybe wider if you want. Knees are bent. We're going to just loosen that all up. So very strong, and then we just follow with a nice loosening, soft twist. And you can just turn to look right behind you, bending into the knees. So everything is, the body's upright, but everything else is kind of soft and flowing. Good. Breathe, breathe, breathe. In and out through the nostrils. A few more of these just to loosen everything up. Feel that freedom in the body. Just using that internal rotation just to create that space in the body. And we're going to just do a little connection of the energy. So cross crawl, lifting the left knee, meeting it with the right hand, and then the opposite way as well. And we'll do this quite slowly. Breathing in and out through the nostrils the whole time. A little cross crawl motion. Just noticing how it impacts on you. Your brain-body connection, coordination. And we'll just do one more of these. Take the leg out to the side and the opposite arm goes over the head. And this other one can kind of reflect that upper arm. So making a little circle around our head and upper body. Really try and expand that leg out to the side. Breathing in and out the nostrils the whole time, keeping that steady flow, the energy flow. And feeling your body, really feeling, how does my body feel? What's happening? And then come to a stop. And then we're going to just sweep out. So anything that maybe is hanging around still, we want to just sweep that out. We're going to do a half breath. So inhaling, stretch up, and then exhaling. Any old rubbish that's there hanging around, clinging on, let's just sweep it out. Inhaling. Out through the mouth. Good. Let's try that again. Inhaling. Bending the knees, let the arms swing. Let's do one more of these. Inhale. Let's set the hands in front and behind as well. Opening the shoulders up a little bit more. And just livelying up the arms. Waking us up with this little hand clapping. Maybe giving ourselves a round of applause. Yeah, why not? Okay. Shaking the legs and hands out. Yeah. Okay, so we're going to start off our standing with Trikonasana, triangle. So feet hips width apart, standing nice and tall. Think about your posture. Lift the chest, drop the shoulders. Think about the position of your pelvis, pointing the tailbone down, strong belly here. Thighs engage slightly there. Put the weight on the left foot, and we just step back with the right. Hit the feet in alignment, so you can see the feet, the back of the left heel. If you drew a line, it would hit the middle of the right foot in a nice square there. Inhale, lift the arms up. Exhale, bring the arms down to shoulder height. Breathing in, open the chest. Yeah, breathe in that fresh air. Exhaling, reaching over to the left and down, making contact with that left leg and reaching up away with the right hand. So have a sense of pressing. Rather than gripping with the toes, think about pressing with the toes, particularly that left foot there, the big toe of that left foot, really press into the ground. And imagine that is pressing the ground and the right fingers, the fingers here are reaching up away from that toe. That gives a nice feeling of connectivity and everything extending away from the center, expanding. The neck is also extending out of the body, shoulders down away from the ears. Soften the knees and breathe deeply. One more breath in and out. Use the next inhale to lift you up. And exhale out through the nostrils there. Bend into the right knee, come back to the front of the mat. Weight onto the right, step back with the left. Find your feet. Get the weight even between the feet. Really plant the feet there. Inhale, lift the arms up. Exhale, bring the arms to shoulder height. Drop the shoulders down, lifting the chest. Inhale, open the chest, palms facing forward. Exhale, reaching over to the right and down. Make contact with that right leg. Reaching up away with the left hand. Breathing deeply. In and out through the nostrils.
Keep that neck long, shoulders down away from the ears, soften the knees. Pressing into the big toe of the right foot, so this will help steady. Not gripping with the toes, instead really feeling that connection with the toes, feet and the ground, feeling yourself grounded. Using the inhale to come up.
Exhale, lower the arms down, bend into the left knee, come back to the front of the mat. Take a moment there, some of the legs, just give the legs a little bit of a shake. They're gonna feel good there, keeping the feet on the ground. Ah, yeah, make some sound. And okay, let's come into the hips as well. I just wanna join in. And the shoulders. Ah, shake it all up there. Oh, so it brings so much warmth to the body as well, a little bit shaking, it's good. And we're gonna step back now into Peaceful Warrior. So put the weight on the left foot, a big step back with the right foot. And you can make that a little bit bigger if you need to. Toes pointing forward to that back foot. Hips are level and facing the long edge of the mat. Inhale, lift the arms up, lift the chest. Exhale, bring the arms to shoulder height. Breathing in, expand fingertip to fingertip, but take the shoulders down. Exhaling, bending into that left knee. It's going in line with the toes. Keeping the right heel pushed back, left knee going forwards. Fingertips moving away from each other. Good. And then we're going to come into the peaceful. Breathing in. As you breathe out, reaching back with that right hand. And as the right hand goes down, the left arm goes up. Just keeping them in that alignment. And you can lean heavily onto that strong back leg because it's really pressed into the ground. Turn the left hand and reaching over the body. Checking that you haven't lost the bend in the front knee. You're still deep in that bend. Good. So opening right across the hips. There's so much expansion happening here. This is one of my favorite postures. I just love the openness of it. And it's grounded and it's expressive. So you do need to keep that front foot, the weight of it, very strong. So we're going to come out of it now. So use the inhale to come back to warrior. Arms up. And exhale, sink into warrior two, just for a second. Inhale, straighten the legs. Exhale, lower the arms down. Bend into that right knee, bring yourself back to the front of the mat. Just take a moment there. Shift the weight to the right foot and step back with the left, big step. So get the feet nicely positioned, feel the weight even, get the hips in a nice position. Don't forget, always thinking about this pelvic area, point the tail, strong belly, supporting front and back, inhale. Exhale, bring the hands to shoulder height, inhale. Expand, exhale, bending into that right knee. And as the right knee goes forward, you're making this whole back leg really strong and anchored so that we can go back and lean onto it for our peaceful warrior. Inhale, exhale, reaching back with that left hand. And as the left hand goes down, the right arm goes up. You can press into that left leg, keep the left arm straight, and then turn the right arm so the palm is facing the mat, facing the ground. And reaching over the body, you can look up on the inside of this arm to the ceiling if you're able to do that. Keep the bend in the right knee and breathe. So there's a lot of engagement here. It's a strong posture. Good. And use the next inhale to come back up. Find yourself in warrior. Exhale, sink into it. Really expand. Don't forget these fingertips. Don't forget these arms, engagement there. And use the inhale to straighten up. Exhale, lower the arms down. Bend into the left knee and bring yourself back to the front of the mat. Let's give ourselves another little shake up here. So I'm just going to give the knees a little shake. So knees are bent there, and the hips, and the shoulders. The arms are just flopping around as well. We'll make some sound. Ah, it feels good to do that. Take the feet wide apart. I'm going to come into a wide leg forward bend here. So nice and wide as you can. And we're going to come down to it with a straight arms, or you can hold your back if you prefer. So inhaling. And as you exhale, you're coming forward, but leading with the chest, and the hands are coming down to the sides. You need to bend your knees, you can. And we're going to reach down to the ground. Okay. Now, as you inhale, we're going to come up on the fingertips, look forwards, chest is forwards, and exhale, forward bend. Good. And you can try that again just to give yourself a bit of space. Inhale, look forwards, chest is coming forwards onto the fingertips, and exhaling, just trying to bring the hands
a bit flat to the ground. If you need to bend your knees, you can do that. Let's do one more time coming up and exhaling, coming down to the ground. Good. And let the head hang now. And if you want to, you can take your hands back through the legs behind and place the backs of the hands on the ground. See how it feels. If it feels a bit wobbly, it doesn't feel stable, then just keep the hands here in the center. It's up to you and where you're at. Good. Come back to center if you're not there already. We'll have a little walk over to the right foot. Maybe walk around. See how that is over there. See how far around we can walk. And then we'll walk back, come through the middle. And then we're going to walk the hands over to the left. We're going to walk around, see how it is. See how far around we can reach. Watching the hands with our eyes. Following the hands back to center again. And then we're going to come up on the fingertips, look forwards, take the hands to the hips or waist. So straight back, straight legs, strong buttocks and legs, strong belly in particular. Lifting the elbows, so the body is straight here. Just holding there, and then using the inhale to come back up to standing. Good, and then release. I'm going to do something slightly different, still on a forward bend. We're going to insert the fingers behind the back now. Letting the hands rest there on the back. Leading with the chest. So inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, taking the chest forwards. Keeping the legs strong, so not locking the knees. We're softening the knees slightly. And we're coming forwards into a forward bend again, but letting the arms just rest on the back to begin. And then we're going to take the hands over the body. So we're breathing here. Breathe, breathe, breathe. Just let the weight of the arms do the work. We don't have to really push or shove at all. We're just letting the weight of the arms do the work. With the breath, just opening the shoulders up there. Good. Breathe deeply is the key. And then we just let the hands come, still interlinked, into the center of the back. And we just draw a little circle clockwise on the back, just to create some freedom and space in the back. And then as we do the opposite direction, bend the knees a little bit and just let yourself uncurl to standing. As you're doing that circling motion. Let me rub the back a little bit, why not? Okay, let me just bring the legs together. Legs a little shake. Okay, so we're going to come into a balance now. Standing balance. We're going to come into Warrior Three. So I think it's a little bit of a cool day here. So I want to get a bit of heat in my body. So I'm going to come onto the right foot to begin. When we stand on the left, so I'm just changing that for myself to see how it feels. Take all the weight into that foot. Try not to grip with the toes. Bent knee to begin and lift the back leg. You can either point the toe or push the heel away. And as you take that leg higher, you extend the arms forward. If you need something to hold on to, use a wall or a piece of furniture. That's okay. And the position I like to make is this Jupiter Mudra, interlinking the fingers and pointing the index finger. So that does help. Or you can have a different position with your hands if you prefer. You know, there's lots of other, you can do this little bird motion. I quite like palms together or even hands separated. So try which one you prefer. Breathe. Once you're there, breathe. Try and watch out. This is a very typical thing. Watch out for this hip. It will want to come up, this left hip. But try and keep that down. That's going to be much more work. But this is where we're moving towards. Breathe. Stay strong. Breathe deeply. Your breath is your fuel here. It's your steadiness. It's your anchor. Now use the inhale to come back up. And release. Good. Let's just lift the shoulders up and roll them back. Just to give a little brief pause in between the sides. Okay, other side now. So we're standing on the left foot. Take the weight into that foot, maybe bending the knee. Start to take the body forward. Start to take that right leg up behind you. Again, you can push the heel away or point the toe. I always favour pointing the toe. I like this sort of feeling as extension it gives me and the engagement with my leg there. And again, with this position with the hands, the Jupiter Mudra, taking that forwards and extending the toe away from the finger away from the toe. Watching out if you're gripping, with the toes. Try not to grip. You can press. This is interesting, you know, taking the big toe, which does help a lot with the balance. And breathe deeply. Come up on the inhale and release. Yes. So nice when that's finished. Okay. And we're going to come into a ragdoll. So to release this, bend the knees and just let yourself disintegrate. Let the head, feel the weight of the head. It's pulling you down. Let the arms hang. Breathing in and out through the nostrils all the time. And just letting the body hang. And letting the whole body hang from the hips. Everything is just pouring into the ground. Breathe in through the nostrils. Sigh out through the mouth. Good. And slowly lifting from the base of the spine. Slowly lifting. Keep the arms hanging. The head is hanging. The knees are bent. We're breathing in and out the whole time as we unfurl. As we uncurl, as we come slowly up to standing. And again, rolling the shoulders back as we come to standing, just to enjoy openness in the shoulders, in the body. Okay. Another balance, why not? We're going to come into tree balance. So take the weight onto the left foot. Again, you can bend the standing knee. That helps me definitely to begin. Focus your eyes, breathe. Find that point of focus. This is what we're looking for in the balances. And either with the toes on the ground, putting the foot on the ankle, or the foot on the calf, or high on the inside thigh, pressing firmly with that foot, and also pressing the thigh back. So we're getting pressing to the center line, taking the knee out to the side. Whichever position your foot is, the knee is out to the side. Lift the chest away from that foot. Inhale, lift the arms up, bring the hands together above the head, and then we'll bring them into the heart center, the prayer position. So you feel the chest is lifting towards the palms here, and the palms are pressing together, the same as the foot and the thigh, pressing together. The crown is lifting here. Back of the neck is long, and the foot is, or the roots are pressing down into the earth. From the sole of the foot. So I feel that sense of, wow, aliveness, expression of tree. Everything is very alive, very upright, but also it's moving slightly in the wind, but very rooted, very stable. It would take a hurricane to move this tree. Good. Let's take another breath. And we're going to come out slowly. So first of all, just the arms, inhaling and exhaling, lower the arms down. And then we're just going to grab that right knee, give it a squeeze, lift it up high. And let the leg lower down through space if you can, slowly. And then give the legs a good shake in between. Yeah. Okay. Weight into the right foot. Find that point of focus again. Return to that focus, that drishti point. Find that and breathe. So keep that softness around it. And then find the position for your left foot now. Again, pressing towards this center line and allowing that center line to feel that sense of lift up through that center and also from the bottom of the body sinking down. So we have this extension, extending from the belly up and down. Inhaling, we're going to have the arms outstretched now. See a real expression of tree. Maybe let's have the arms expressed and palms open to receive. Yes, so it's like receiving the light into the body, expressing through the branches, through the arms and the fingers, extending up. Yeah, breathe. Feel the roots going down to the sole of the foot, drawing up nourishment from the earth, and just feel that expression of tree. How does it feel to be a tree? And all the while the breath moving, life force moving in the body, and your focus steady and stable. Good, bring the hands up together, inhaling and exhaling. The hands are coming down to prayer position. Let me grab this knee again.
Give it a squeeze and then let it release to the ground. Legs might want a little shake. Let's shake the arms as well. Why not? Shaking. Yeah, feels good to shake. And we're just going to stand for a moment now. Now we've found a bit of balance. Let's bring that balance into our universal gratitude prayer. So we bring the hands together, the soles of the feet are on the ground, the feet are parallel, they are about hips width apart, the palms pressed together, and we lift the chest towards the heavens. Chin lightly tucked in, back of the neck really long. Close your eyes for a moment. Just check you're not locking your knees or gripping with the toes. Feel your breath. Notice if you're holding your breath. Notice if your breath is shallow. Just let it just expand a little more. Breathing in and breathing out. Let's just express this moment. Inhaling. As you exhale, pointing the fingers towards the ground, watching the fingers there, and inhaling, opening up, expanding the fingers out in a big wide circle, reaching up as high as you can, bring the hands together, and then taking that hand on a little journey together, right down through the very center, pointing to the earth again, watching the hands. So doing this in time with your breath, whatever speed you're going out, try and keep the pace smooth and steady, steady, steady pace, exhaling to the ground. And in this little gesture, this movement, we bring in the layers of gratitude and appreciation. What do I appreciate right now in this moment? What is there for me within myself, without myself, and actually, you know, all of it? Maybe there is no inside and outside of myself. Maybe. Breathing in. Appreciation and gratitude. And just notice the feeling. What is the feeling of appreciation and gratitude for what is? Yeah. And then what do we need as well? What do we want to receive? Just bring that into our little prayer here, our embodied universal prayer. Just reaching up, drawing in whatever I need, whatever I want to receive. So increasing our capacity to receive. It's all there waiting for us. So we're just becoming a bit more receptive to what we need. For our growth, our evolution, our well-being, our healing. What do I need? Make this the last one. Let the hands come down and rest this time at the heart center. So wherever you are in your gesture, your movement, just let the hands, when they get there, just rest at the heart center, pressing together evenly with the hands, lifting the chest towards the hands and closing the eyes. Noticing if you're gripping the toes, lift the toes, place them down, soften the knees. Feel the crown of the head lifting. That silver thread from the center, the top of the crown, going up into the universe, connecting you to the universe, to the cosmos. And the soles of the feet, the roots going down, the earthly embodied, going down into the center of the earth. Everything is just beneath our feet. Whole unexplored territories. And breathing and holding and noticing in the center of this, in the center of my center, feeling a sense of your centeredness from the top of the head to the roots going down from the sole of the feet. Feel the center of that center line, the heart center. Noticing how does it feel today. Giving that a moment to be interested and curious in your experience and in this very particular part of your experience, your heart. How does it look, feel, smell, taste? Okay, dropping the hands down. We'll give it a little bit of movement now. So now we find this centeredness, we're going to move with that centered feeling with a half sun salute. Inhaling, reaching up. palms come together, exhaling the arms coming down, the knees bend, the chest leads. Notice how strong the belly has to be to do this. Fingertips touch the ground. Now straighten the legs, look forwards, hands come on the knees. Inhale. Exhale, forward bend with the straight legs. And then we bend the knees a lot more so that we can inhale and push up through the legs, reach up, exhale, arms come down. Inhale all the way up. Look up, exhale, lead with the chest, lead with the chin and the chest. Knees bend, fingertips touch the ground. Inhale, exhale, forward bend. Bend the knees a lot. Inhale all the way up. You can do this in your own time. If you know this sooner, you can choose your time. You can go faster or slower. Whatever you're doing, just notice what's happening. Knees bend, fingertips touch the ground. Looking at the ground, looking forwards, opening the chest, shoulders back. Exhale, forward bend. Bend the knees a lot. Inhale. Look up, reach up on that inhale, exhale, soften everything. Everything is softening, returning to the earth. You feel your feet on the ground, then we reach up again. Reach up to the heavens, then we reach to the ground. Bend the knees, fingertips. Inhale, now straighten the legs, back and arms, look forwards, and exhale, forward bend with the straight legs. Bend the knees, inhale all the way up. Use your breath, go with your breath, follow your breath. So it's an inhale, and we reach up with that inhale, and we reach forwards with the exhale, the knees bend. If you touch the ground, then we inhale, the heart opens and fills with air, and then we exhale, bring it to the ground, bend the knees. The inhale lifts us up, we're flying, and then we're coming back down to earth. Just notice just the quality of the breath. Inhale, exhale, bend the knees, fingertips touch the ground. Inhale, open, exhale, earthing, bend the knees. Inhale, flying upwards. Exhale, arms come down. Let's do one more of these. Really feel the breath is moving the body. Make it big and expressive breath. Bend the knees, fingertips touch the ground. Inhale, straighten the legs, arms and back. Take the shoulders back, spread, open the chest. Exhale, forward bend, strong legs. Strong back, bend the knees. Look up and reach up on the inhale, reach up. And exhale, release, release, release. Good. Take a moment to breathe in and out. Just to see how that feels. Being still, feeling the movement of the breath, still in the body. Good. I'm going to come down to the breath. Returning to the ground where we started. So we bring the arms in front of us, the feet are hips width apart and parallel. Slow squat, so take the shoulders back. Inhale, as you exhale, you take the bottom back, take the hands forward, strong belly here. Slowly as you can, breathing in and out the whole time. We're only gonna do this once today. So try and really feel it. Enjoy the aliveness of your body and take the hands behind. Stretch the legs out in front. We're returning to forward bend. We did this earlier. See how it feels now. Bring the legs together, toes pointing towards the ceiling. Take that fleshy part back a little bit. So does your body feel a bit warmer? Is there maybe the backs of the thighs, the hamstrings a little bit warmer? Inhale, reach up, look up at the back of the hands, and then leading with the chest. The chest is coming forwards. It's coming towards the toes. Imagine that. Let the hands rest on the ground or the legs, doesn't really matter so much. Inhaling, coming away a little bit. So it's not just coming away, it's also lengthening in the spine, dropping the shoulders down, the chest is leading. Really leading this, the sternum, middle of the chest. Breathing in and out. If you can reach the big toes comfortably or the sides of the feet, and that's quite good to get the first two fingers hooked around those toes, but not if you're, you know, kind of coming out of your alignment and you're kind of selling yourself short there. And it does help having that kind of contact, and you can always put something around the bottom of the feet, like a belt, a sock, a scarf, anything like that is useful. Breathing in and breathing out. Even closing the eyes to see how it feels rather than how you think it should look. Just taking yourself away from that
exterior, outside idea of ourselves. Now we're going to come out of this, inhaling, reaching up, exhaling, taking the arms down. And we're going to lie down at last. So we're going to do this slowly though, reaching towards the toes with the fingers. Keep that tension going, but keep the softness and the energy flowing by breathing out, in and out continually as you keep yourself in this tension. Yeah, that's what keeps it interesting. But you can breathe through things, you can hold and you can make effort, but you keep the breath moving. And then lying on the ground, let's just hug the knees. It's going to feel nice after all of that effort. Yeah, have a little rock side to side. Ease out the back. Breathe, release. Breathing in through the nostrils. Sighing out from the mouth. Yeah, just enjoy that. Then we're going to extend the heels to the ceiling. Extend the fingers to the ceiling and then rotate the wrists and ankles. Try and do that slowly as well. Just enjoying the wrists and ankles. You can even bring that into the elbows and arms if you want to. Just feel that flowing movement. And we rotate in the other direction if you can. Try the opposite. Just feel that movement. What's happening in the ankles? What happens to the rest of the legs? Can you feel that in the calves and in the shins? And then we just hug the knees again. Have another little rock and roll. Maybe we'll draw a circle this time. Keeping the hands on top of each kneecap, and we just draw a big circle on the ground and also draw a big circle with the knees. Knees staying together. Inhaling and exhaling. Drawing the knees in, expanding on the inhale and contracting on the exhale. And we'll go the other direction. If you want to, you can let go the knees and just let the knees go on their own. If you want to make a bigger circle, that's kind of nice. It's a bit more effort here. So you can just choose what you want to do there. Hug the knees once more. Sole the feet on the ground. Slide the legs away. And let's give ourselves a full extension. Take the arms up above the head. Yeah, point the toes. Bring the legs together. Point the toes and extend the fingers away. Breathing in, and as you breathe out, push the heels away. Point the toes on the inhale. Push the heels away on the exhale. Just feeling that. Noticing what's being impacted as you do this. You know, it's a very simple little thing, but just see what's being impacted. I can feel that right into the front of my hip flexor there as I point the toes, and I can feel that even into my lower back as I push the heels away. Very nice little simple practice. Take the feet away from each other now, we're just coming out of that. So let the arms rest on the ground, the elbows slightly bent. Back of the neck is nice and long, so chin is slightly tucked in. Relax the legs. So we just flop them side to side to remind them they don't need to do anything now. Inhaling fully into the nostrils, exhaling fully out through the nostrils as the arms move through space. So beautiful, simple little practice. This simple little practice, I've been doing this for so long. It's very simple and it really works. It's not always easy because of the mind, really. You know, the mind wants to keep wandering off. So that this simple little practice of moving and breathing, it's like a moving meditation in a way, you know. It's like, can I keep my mind on just this, on the arms moving smoothly and steadily and moving in time with the breath? And I can do this with my eyes closed as well. See how it feels with the eyes closed. Notice, does it feel any different with the eyes closed? What is your experience when you close the eyes? Inhaling all the way up. And exhaling. And moving through space. And just notice and feel that the breath is getting maybe a bit slower. As we move, making this last one, we'll do last one of a whole inhale and a whole exhale, just enjoying this, thinking this is the closing
movement of this little practice. It's a great little take home, this one. You can do this anytime. You can obviously do the same kind of thing, but standing as well. And finally, we'll just hug the knees one more time. Why not? Squeeze the knees in. Even lift the head up, make yourself into a very small little seed. And then release down. And then we'll put the feet on the ground. And we'll slide the legs away. We're going to do a bit of abdominal breathing to take us into a short relaxation. So I might want to give belly a little rub, actually. And I kind of felt like, oh, I want to give my belly a little rub. Why not? Or maybe the hips need a little bit there as well. Maybe even putting the hands underneath the lower back, giving that a little bit of a rub. Yeah, this whole area always needs lots. So you can leave your hands on your belly if you want to, just letting the arms rest easily by the side, even if it's just the fingers there, just to feel the movement there. Making sure the back of the neck is long. So if our chin is lifted, then you're going to need to have something underneath your head, a small cushion or rolled folded blanket. So we're going to do some abdominal breathing. Close the eyes, let the legs relax. If you find it easier to have your feet on the ground and let the knees fall together, you can do that as well. In fact, I'm going to do that just to see how that is. So as you inhale, feel the belly expand. And as you exhale, feel the belly contract slowly. We're trying to keep this smooth and slow. Abdominal breathing. So make sure your whole rest of your body is relaxed, particularly the mouth and the jaw. Take it to the end of the out-breath. Squeeze the breath out. Imagine the belly button is going back and squeezing back towards the back of the body, towards the floor behind the back there. And then as you inhale, slowly let the air in. Full capacity, then let it out slowly. It's like you're controlling the valve there. So the breath is coming in a steady, smooth stream. Steady stream, really letting it out and emptying out. You're attempting to completely empty the breath out. We'll do a couple more of these. Slow, steady breath. Try and particularly lengthen the out breath. And you can either keep that position or you can let the arms flop out to the side. And if your knees are bent, you can keep that position or you can come into Shavasana. We're just transitioning from the abdominal breath into gentler, easier, everyday breath coming in and out through the nostrils. Eyes are still closed. And we're just going to relax here on the ground for a minute. So give yourself fully to this relaxation. Breath coming in and out through the nostrils. Soft, easy breath. Feel the body moving. Feel the body being breathed. Breath coming in and breath going out. Breath is taking care of itself. Breath is taking care of you. And as you feel your body relaxing, melting and softening, just have a sense of opening. Have a sense of opening the heart. And have a sense of expanding, allowing yourself to receive more. So we need to soften, open, particularly the front of the body. Feel the back is supported on the ground and it's just softening and melting into the earth, feeling a strong and stable back, a soft, open front, receptive, open. And the breath is moving and the belly and the chest are moving with that breath, easy, effortless. There's nothing to do here. Allow ourselves to relax and open, soften, relax and open. Feeling the support of the earth, the mother beneath you, support, supporting your whole body, your whole being. Know that you are supported and held and loved by this earth, by this universal mother. And in this moment, we give ourselves to that mother fully. When we come out of our relaxation, short but sweet, take your time. So really carrying whatever was useful for you from this relaxation into your day. You know, just feeling that sense of being held, that sense of being loved, that sense of nourishment that we are can be receptive to all the time. And our receptivity to everything. So opening up that kind of more expansive vision of everything rather than this kind of very blinkered vision, allowing ourselves to receive. Yeah, so we come bring ourselves to seated. I'm just going to, while we do that, taking your time to come to seated, whatever way, I'm just going to, I have this little quote from George Washington Carver, who was an agricultural scientist and inventor who promoted alternative crops to cotton and methods to prevent soil depletion. He was the most prominent black scientist of the early 20th century and has some fantastic things that he said. So I love this. Anything will give up its secrets if you love it enough. Not only have I found that when I talk to the little flower or to the little peanut, they will give up their secrets, but I have found that when I silently commune with people, they give up their secrets also, if you love them enough. And there you go, something lovely for our practice today. So let's take that seed, that beautiful idea there, if you love it enough. And that starts with ourselves. Let's give ourselves some love, bring the hands to our heart center. And let's give ourselves some love. And if we have a sankalpa, an intention that is loving, that is going to increase our capacity to love ourselves and appreciate everything else, and particularly ourselves. And we say that to ourselves, our intention, and take it deep into our heart, hold it, and hold ourselves. And feeling our own healing, which wants to happen all the time. Good. Good. Okay. Namaste. Thank you so much. Okay, so, thank you so much for being here.